My name is Jake Bailey, and today I'm going to be talking about vegetarian diets. Now, in the world, there's about 1.5 billion cows, and if calculated correctly, that fills up about 75% of Africa. But vegetarians eat like this because it's healthy for their body, and as you can tell, with how overpopulated the Earth is, it's very healthy for the Earth. So a few types of vegetarians, I'd like to start by just helping you guys learn what they are, is there's a regular vegetarian, and they don't eat meat, they don't eat fish, they won't eat poultry, or any other animal byproduct. So a couple other types of vegetarians would be lacto-vegetarians, which they'll kind of cheat and they'll avoid eggs, but they'll drink milk, and then ovo-vegetarians, they'll eat meat, or they'll eat eggs, but they won't drink milk. And then some really lazy vegetarians, they'll be lacto-ovo, and they'll eat eggs and they'll drink milk. So I'm not actually a vegetarian currently, but throughout 40 days of Lent, which is like a promise to God, if many of you seem like you're Catholic, so you kind of know what that is, you make a promise to God and you don't break it. So I was vegetarian for 40 days, and a couple of things that I noticed were the meals, they took a very long time to make. You always had to have your food ready and prepped. Secondly, you're going to feel a lot more hungry throughout all of it because the food is a lot less dense compared to the meat that you guys are used to eating. And then having a cookbook or Pinterest or some sort of way to help you find recipes, it's very helpful. And then having no meat in your diet will also, it could have you return with vitamin B deficiency, so you want to be careful. If any of you are vegetarians, you want to make sure you have a better way to supplement vitamin B in your diets. So the positive impact that eating a vegetarian diet has on the earth is it depopulates farms, which, like I said earlier, with the amount of cows on earth, it kind of makes them cut how many animals they're supposed to have. And currently, it is nitrogen, which is the highest greenhouse gas, and then after that, it's methane, and then after that, it's CO2, which is actually transportation. And all this methane that is being emitted into the air is currently being emitted from farm animals, and this is actually according to thehumanesociety.org, which measures emissions in the United States. So this is a little bar graph of all the, or a little pie graph of the emissions. Right here, the nitrogen, which is the most, and then it's CO2, which is our transportation, and then finally, it's the methane, and all this methane is being emitted from cows, sheep, and pigs. So a couple of the benefits on your body that vegetarian health habits will do is it's going to reduce your chances of obtaining all these health conditions up here, which is obesity, coronary artery disease, which is just blockage of the arteries, hypertension, diabetes, some types of cancers, and then blood clots as well. And then this was actually according to a study published by Dr. Rajadeen. She collected 2,000 people who had never smoked or drank in their life, and then over the course of 5 years, they've let them know how tightly they're following the vegetarian diet. And throughout the course of 5 years, if they weren't following it, she noticed that a lot of the people who were not following it were starting to get a lot worse health conditions. So throughout my speech, I did not intend on persuading any of you guys to eat a vegetarian lifestyle. If you do decide, if you're inspired, please consult your physician first, especially if you have current health conditions. And since you have the info that I do, hopefully you can be more self-aware of the footprint that you leave on this earth.